those moves, and there's a few more coming your way in a second. Now, these lot hardly need an introduction. They're here to perform their brand new single, Everybody in Love. It's JLS.
Everybody in love, gon' put your hands up. Everybody in love, gon' put your hands up. Everybody in love, gon' put your hands up. If you're in love, put your hands up. When we need someone, when they need so strong. When they're gone, you don't know how to go on. So the whole world is stuck in a moment, standing still until they come back. You accept that they got things to do, but sometimes in the end there's nothing left for you. If hurt is missing you, baby, I've done too much of it lately. Cause every minute's like an hour, every hour's like a day, every day lasts forever. But what else am I gonna do? I'll wait forever and a day for you. I'd wait up, wait up. I can't eat, I can't sleep. What else could it be? So deep, long as I'm where you're going to. I'll be forever and a day for you. I'll wait up for you.
Oh, oh, wait up for you.
Even when we're mad and say we're through, deep inside you feel the same way I do. Might as well turn around and just end this, cause it's hard trying to stay mad. I can tell you that you can't stay here, knowing just as soon as you disappear that I'll be missing you, baby, soon as you get up and you walk away.
Cause every minute's like an hour, every hour's like a day, every day lasts forever. But what else am I gonna do? I'll wait forever and a day for you. I'd wait up, wait up. I can't eat, I can't sleep. What else could it be? So deep, long as I'm where you're going to. I'll wait forever and a day for you. I'll wait up, wait up. Everybody in love, don't put your hands up. Everybody in love, don't put your hands up. Everybody in love, don't put your hands up. If you're in love, put your hands up.
Put your hands. So deep, long as I'm where you're going to. I'll wait forever and a day for you. I'll wait up for you.
JLS, everybody. Oh my goodness.
That was fantastic.
You literally just wooed Helen with your voice.
And I'm getting old. Red and embarrassed now. Fantastic performance.
Good
thank
to
you
have
so much for coming in.
Thanks.
And we're lucky to have you in. You're flying all over the shop at the minute, aren't you? You're
we
really
are.
Busy.
Yeah, it's been incredible. Obviously, performed in the X Factor recently, and you know, we've been. It's been amazing.
Gigs
yeah.
and
yeah.
Yeah. Busy.
And you're on tour as well, aren't you?
Yes, in February.
Oh wow, fantastic. Well, you've got some pretty big celebrity fans.
Oh, look,
including Barney the Doc. Mate,
he
just zoomed in as soon as you guys arrived. Well, T.T. Strider likes you guys. He performed for us last week. And James Duty Dench as well, M from James Bond. I mean, like, talk to me about this Hollywood endorsement.
She's like movie royalty.
She is like royalty. She's a real legend. And I have to say, you have loads and loads of fans by the Blue Peter message boards. We've been absolutely inundated. Polly Whatever says she's a huge fan and plays your songs up to 100 times a day.
Good girl.
Wow. That's dedication.
Thank you. That's
her
dedication.
Parents get a bit annoyed at song number 99. Cutie Little Bug 09 loves your music and wants to know who takes the longest to get ready.
Arishe.
It's the hair, isn't it? It's the hair.
It's the hair. But Andy, we understand this. Bro.
This is his hair talk, boy. This is hair talk. Okay. I get you. I get you.
He's
talking about the
hours.
Talking about the relaxing.
I'll let you know about that.
I'm talking about the relaxing.
What?
All right, boy talk. Right, we've got silent pause. Who's the best at breakdancing and what's the best moves that you know? Who's the best at breakdancing?
Go on,
probably Aston.
Aston, let's see what you got. Come on, you have to.
Go on.
Do a windmill or something.
Do us a windmill. Do us a windmill.
A windmill.
Yeah, go on then.
Well done.
I'm so.
Oh, look at him getting ready, getting prepared.
You're so uncool.
I don't even know what a windmill is.
Oh, it's a great breakdancer. It's when he twists his leg.
Not that I'm a.
Let's just take
it. Go on, Aston.
Go on, Aston. Go on,
Aston.
Aston. Aston. Go on, Aston. Go on, do it then.
Right.
Joel's gonna be honestly, he's not even here to see this. He would have loved to see you do that.
No, Joel would have got the robot out
actually,
and tried to make
you
incorporate
that. I don't
know if
the robot could compete with that.
Now we know a lot of your fans have been inspired by your dance moves. Ashley and Lauren in particular want you to have a look at these moves.
Okay.
Look at
the skills. Skills.
That's
okay,
cool.
Skills.
Wow. Look at that.
That baby freeze.
Wow. Oh, look, right. I want to be part of JLS. I've always wanted to be part of JLS. I want to do that little baby freeze. Or,
be careful.
Hey! Do I get the gig? Can I come on tour, boys? It's like that.
You're on tour.
You're there, man.
Technical contract, everybody.
Can anybody else do it?
What, baby freeze?
Yeah, do it, David. Baby freeze.
Crit one.
Go on. All right, that's the show. Go on. Reshake. Go on then.
Sorry.
I'm just crit walking back into my chair, you see?
We're getting a lot of these today.
These boys are born performers.
You're sticking around because you're going to help us do a T-shirt a bit later on, so you can carry on your audition.
Yes.
Because you are going to get involved with our appeal, Send a Smile. Now, this year, we're working with a charity called Operation Smile, and we want you to make medical gowns out of old T-shirts. Now, a lot of the children that I met in India need a cleft palate operation and a cleft lip operation, but most of them haven't seen a doctor before, so we needed to make sure that they were fit and healthy for surgery before they went anywhere. 5-year-old Nisha is hoping she'll be one of the lucky ones and get an operation. This is just the start of a whole series of assessments that Nisha will go through so that the doctors can get lots of information about her. And then when it comes to deciding who's actually going to get an operation, we've got all that information that can work out who should go to the front of the queue. These are really standard tests. I mean, everybody has their blood pressure taken at one point or another, but a lot of children like Nisha have never even been to a doctor, let alone had anything like this done.
I'm Pear, this is Dr. Hugh.
She's got a new dress.
First, Nisha's examined by one of the surgeons, Pear Hall.
Okay, thank you. Okay, say, Pear's is normal. And the gum is normal, so it's just an incomplete cleft lip.
As a doctor who treats this in the UK, you know, children are sorted at birth, aren't they?
Well, at 3 months for a lip, yes.
And how does it make you feel to see so many children like Nisha?
Well, it makes you feel like you've got to keep coming back.
So to the next doctor.
Nisha has a cleft lip, which should be easy to repair. But doctors also need to make sure she's healthy enough to have surgery. And Dr. Phil, the anaesthetist, has just found a problem.
Phil's just found out that Nisha had asthma and often gets a cold, which means that putting her under anaesthetic so that she can have the operation might be quite complicated and it might cause her some problems. To be honest, it's not looking good at the minute.
If she was still very wheezy, we may not be able to do the operation. Whereas if we give her the treatment...
Nisha's breathing problems need to get better before she can safely have surgery. Doctors want everyone to have the best chance of getting an operation, and in Nisha's case, something as simple as an asthma inhaler solves the problem. She is going to get her operation. Less than an hour in surgery, and Nisha's life is transformed. This simple operation has changed everything for Nisha. She's got a whole new life ahead of her, and I feel really lucky to be here for the start of it. Through Send a Smile, we can provide more operations to give other children the chance of having the surgery they desperately need, so they can go home with a new future, just like Nisha.
Now, Now, Nisha's lip was still a little bit swollen, but that'll go down, and her life has been completely transformed. I couldn't believe the number of children that I met who can't go to school, who don't have many friends, all because they have a cleft lip. And you can help fix that, can't they, Andy?
They can. We want you to design some gowns out of old T-shirts. Look, we've got some celebrities to help us out. Look, Alicia Dixon's made this really nice one. She even had time to plug a single, Breathe Slow. We've also got Fern Cartonnet, look at that. Nice little hearty motif. Bit of CBBC royalty here, Ian and Hacker. That is really impressive. Look at those cartoons. That's smooth. And of course, Frankie from the Saturdays, a little nice smile. She's lovely. We've also got the boys from JLS to help us out. Oh yes, these boys are getting creative. You're going to be reminding us how to get a gown, how to make a gown. Sorry. What do you think of our appeal, Ian?
Our appeal is fantastic. You know, it's great to be a part of it. All of these amazing celebrities,
and you're here with us to do it as well.
That's right.
All right, Marvin, we're going to start from the top. Okay. This is the first step on how to make a gown.
So we've each got one of our coloured T-shirts, and obviously we're going to customise this. But the first thing we need to do is make sure that they're nice and clean. So I'm going to smell the armpit.
Mate.
It's fresh.
That was mine before. I'm just fresh anyway.
But no, you smell fresh.
Yeah, who's the smelliest of the group?
Probably Marvin.
Yeah. No. Mate, you need to put that T-shirt on after the show. It's fine. Step two.
OK, next stage, we're going to take our T-shirt, and we're not going to cut the front, we're going to cut the back of the T-shirt. It's very important that you cut the back of it.
There you go.
Thank you. Got some scissors.
It's like a little helper.
It's like a little helper, you know? At Christmas time.
I'm here to please.
Helper.
Okay.
Do you want some help?
Yeah. Everyone pull it. This is a group effort.
This will be the back of the T-shirt. That's why you're slitting.
There we go.
You're cutting it straight out. This is a fantastic
thing.
This is why these guys are brilliant.
I'm cutting all over the place.
All right.
Do not do it like me.
Do not worry. Okay, now, step three.
Step three, anyway. Now, put a couple of dots in there already, but what you need to do is once you put the slit in the back of your T-shirt, as you can see, you need to start adding these little X's just here, and you're going to make six holes, okay? Now, make one more little mark here. With scissors, Arisha, may I have the scissors?
Yes, you may.
May I have
Thank you. That's the right way to pass scissors.
While he's cutting it, can we get step four on?
Step four, once you've got your holes, like Aston, you can then start attaching the ribbon.
Very beautiful ribbon.
In order to tie the gown at the back.
Very nice. Mate, you've tied ribbons before. I like this.
I'm a good ribbon tie.
This is great.
I've been working hard at this.
Okay, now once you've done that, all you need to do is customise your T-shirt. These boys, I've got loads of equipment here. Any JLS tips on customising?
Go colour. Absolutely crazy. Use red, blue, green and yellow. Just go crazy.
Colour.
Yeah. Or any other colour. Right, yeah. So many of you have been making some gowns as well. We've got one here from Jacob and Benjamin. Check this one out. Very nice little rainbow motif. Styling it out there.
Very nice.
We've got another one here from Isabella. Brilliant. Looking good. She wears that with pride. And then Martha, hey, what more can I say? Looking good indeed. And all these pictures have come from the Gangari. Head over there if you lost for a little bit of inspiration.
Oh. Mind you, I think you'll be inspired after seeing these. They're looking good. I'm impressed.
Yes.
Quite a tough act to follow, though. There's some good T-shirts back there.
Oh, it's okay.
More glitter, I say, always more glitter. While you carry on, though, I'm going to throw out some more questions from our message boards. Brown Cheeky Cookie wants to know, I don't think she was christened that, but maybe a he.
Maybe he.
If you had not been popular as singers, what would you have done?
Oh. I'd been a footballer.
Yeah?
Yeah. I would have done that.
I think me, I would have tried to be a Blue Peter presenter.
Don't worry,
you ain't getting a job, mate.
You're coming to your job.
Swapsies.
What's what? What's
what? I don't know, the hair looks the same.
Exactly, what's what?
Come on.
What would I do? Yeah. I would probably be a T-shirt designer.
Ah,
hey.
Wow. Brilliant.
Not a good one. I would have been a doctor.
A doctor?
A doctor. Very noble. A mega JLS lover says, what do you think of X Factor this year? Who has been your favourite performer so far?
We really like Ollie.
Yeah, he's strong.
And Stacey.
I like John and Edward.
Yeah?
The
people's favourite.
I think they're great. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. They're entertaining.
They are entertaining.
Yeah, they're fun. I like that.
They're all great. They're all really good.
Nice one.
Well, you keep carrying on there. You don't need that much glitter.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll
see these later on, all right?
Sparkles.
We will see your T-shirts at the end of the show, and we won't judge you. Much.
Please don't.
Sadly, I could not say the same for Joel and myself. Now, he's off judging the Me and My Movie competition, but before he went, we had a little contest of our own. We each designed a T-shirt, and the winner got to strut their stuff on a catwalk during London Fashion Week. Now, come on, who's got more style, me or him?
Two presenters, three judges, one catwalk.
It's London Fashion Week. Every September, London is whipped into a fashion frenzy when the movers and shakers of the international fashion world descend on the city. And this year, we're right in the thick of it.
Our task? In the next 24 hours, we each need to create our own T-shirt, which we will then model on the catwalk. But there's only room for one of us.
And at the end of the day, a group of fashion experts will judge which one of our T-shirts makes it to the catwalk. And boy, do they know their stuff.
We, on the other hand, don't know a whole lot about fashion.
Methinks we're going to need some help on this one.
Team Helen is me and designer Craig Lawrence. Craig specialises in knitwear design and has made clothes for Lady Gaga. His favourite items of clothing are his socks.
And Team Joel is me, Joel De Vries, and fashion designer Manjit Ju. Manjit graduated from the London College of Fashion and specialises in luxury clothes and sequins. If he were an item of clothing, he'd be a sequin jacket. Our mentors will be working with us at the London College of Fashion to create our own design. They have their work cut out.
Ready, set, go!
Right, so here's a plain white T-shirt.
OK.
Now, give me your ideas.
I hope you'd have more ideas.
Hey, Joel, this is your T-shirt. We can customise it. What's your ideas?
Well, I think me walking down the catwalk will be a bit of a performance anyway, so I reckon big,
definitely
bold.
I'd quite like it to be cool, like quite smart, mm-hmm. but something a bit different.
So maybe we can make a TV, maybe like a something around the edge, and then we can, in the middle we can have like a TV.
Definitely.
Could we make like big fluffy shoulders?
That'd be fun.
Right, well I think we should use this because that's cool.
Yeah, that's nice.
But I also like the feel of that. Do they work?
Well, the colours could work.
Potentially I could be walking down the catwalk,
yeah.
so...
Well, you will.
We will.
We will.
Right, let's just get working, let's just get cracking.
Lots of work to do and a feeling that Joel was working faster than me. Time for a sneaky peek.
Helen's actually come in and having a look. Oi, oi, honestly, don't make me ribbon you up, right? Take the, that's, walk around like that. Don't get near it, all right?
Is it going well?
Just leave.
All right, I'm busy.
All right, just, so competitive. It's...
Really fun.
Keep it though.
We need to impress the judges, don't we? Because so when they see this T-shirt, I want them to think, wow, that Joel, he is the coolest person in the world.
I think Helen's got a good chance of winning.
Ta-da!
She's got bags of energy and lots of enthusiasm and she's brave. I think it's a showpiece worth seeing on the catwalk.
Okay, thank you. Good luck.
With only an hour to go, our designers left us alone to finish our T-shirts.
I'm getting a bit stressed. We're up against time. We haven't got long left.
Right, I'm cutting these sleeves in an attempt to make them look a little bit cooler.
I love the T-shirt. I think the sequins, the shoulder pads, tassels, I think they work really, really well. Does Joel have a future in fashion? I don't know. Maybe. Maybe. His sewing skills weren't too bad, but let's see.
I'm done. I think. Maybe not something you'll see in the shop soon.
There we have it. Ready? This is my creation. Judges, how could you not be impressed by that?
Ta-da!
Wow.
Is it wow or is it obscene?
Well, it's something.
Right, what do you think of my creation?
Looking,
or our creation?
It's looking good. Love the shoulder pads. Love the... What's this?
Yeah, now this is because I thought I wanted to make some tighter sleeves.
No, makes sense, yeah.
But it's just not sewed very well.
What do you think the judges will think of it?
They'll think it's experimental.
That's good, isn't it, in fashion?
Do you think the judges will like it?
God, of course they will. Look, sequins, shoulder pads, gold shoulder pads, tassels.
What's there not to like?
Exactly.
Well done. Good teamwork.
Yeah. The designs were done. The catwalk was calling. It was time to perfect our strut.
How? Shimmy.
Will it look better as well?
Yeah, there we go.
It's like learning to walk. It's so awkward.
Right, let's go win this thing. Bang, walk, shimmy.
Well, there's absolutely nothing more we can add, so let's show it to the judges.
Yeah, come on, let's go.
Meanwhile, across London, the judges were arriving to decide who would get to model their T-shirt on the catwalk, me or Helen. The judges are world-famous fashion designer Luella Bartley, celebrity stylist Hershey Pasquale, and singer and fashion superstar Phoebe Brown.
What would these fashion experts think of our designs?
It was time to face the judges.
How did you come up with this design?
These are blocks, and this is a spaceship trying to break them down.
Okay.
So kind of 80s Space Invader theme.
It's actually far better than I ever thought it would be. So I wanted something quite cool and bold, with like lots of colours, and I think I've achieved that.
Do you have like a particular theme for this look?
Not really.
You had no theme or anything, it's just complete creative freedom. You didn't.
I just had a table full of stuff and I thought,
improvised.
What can I put on here?
Are you happy with it?
Yeah, I like this bit the best, so yeah. I feel like I should have done more with this.
Thank you very much for your comments. I bid you adieu.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
I think that went all right. They seemed kind of intrigued by everything, don't you think?
I don't know what their reaction was.
I think the highlight was we were on trend.
OK, so what do we think of Joel's?
I love the shoulder pads and the tassel. I think that was my favourite bit.
Yeah. He instantly, when he came in, I actually was like, oh, that's quite interesting, quite trendy, quite now. But I don't think he experimented quite as much with the techniques that they've been learning all day.
So what do you think about Helen?
It was really creative. I like
wild.
The fact that she
was yeah.
totally wild and random and fun. I think she's really got into the experimental side of it.
I felt it was like a bit too much. Like there was too much going on.
But then it's quite nice to be wild. Improvise. Right, we've got to try and choose the winner. It's tough, but we have to try and figure out which one's the best.
Yeah.
There we go. Catwalk. Job is done.
We wouldn't find out who the judges had chosen until the following day.
It was the morning we had been waiting for. London Fashion Week was in full swing and we were backstage at the Blow Presents Catwalk Show.
Right, we're backstage at Fashion Week and any minute now one of us is going to have to go out onto that catwalk.
Come on, just do it, do it.
In here.
There could only be one winner. Would it be me?
Oh, me.
Yes, I won!
Good job, DeVries. Now work that catwalk.
Boom, 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 gotta get. 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 Boom, 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 that boom, 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 that boom.
Before I knew it, it was all over. In less than 24 hours, I'd become a fashion superstar. And more than that, I bought the robot to London Fashion Week.
Only Joel would do the robot and the catwalk in London Fashion Week. Absolutely ridiculous. What a disgrace.
I, for one, am gutted that he's not here to celebrate.
Yeah, me too,
oh,
yeah.
Shame.
It's been so quiet without him today. OK,
brilliant.
Now to our Sender Smiler Pool, because we've got JLS here who've been customising some T-shirts for us. Boys, show the nation what you've been making.
Here we go.
Look at that.
There you go.
Isn't that amazing?
With mine, you get a free chain.
That's good.
Aston's harmonised with just a few notes
there. Mine has an earring and everything.
This is
got
brilliant.
Hearts,
look
lips,
at my, look at my little
hands.
Face in the corner of my T-shirt.
That's right.
And like a nice weather theme over here. Right. So thank you very much for those
Boys,
T-shirts, guys.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Sally,
join us tomorrow, next week. We'll have Fix It Lot. We'll be joining us in the studio.
And for more inspiration on what to put on your T-shirt, go to the Blue Peter website. See you next time.
Get creative. Bye-bye.
There's an alien trapped in the internet, and we've got to find it.
It will take human ingenuity to find its precise location.
That could be really dangerous.
We have to find it fast, which we can't do on our own.
Not everyone has what it takes to do what we do.
We need help.
Right, come on, you lot, let's do this.
To join the monster hunt, or to see Secret Cast Diaries, the Sarah Jane Adventures Trailer Maker, and lots more, go to the CBBC website and click on the Sarah Jane Adventures.
Charlie, and I wish that Britain were a sunnier place. If it was more sunny, then I suppose we'd be able to go out a lot more. It would encourage people to be a bit more fit, because when it's raining all the time, people just like to sit inside and do nothing, just watch the telly. But when it's sunny, everybody has a good time and they go out to the park and they play games. It's nice not to have to wear so many clothes when it's sunny. You get to wear T-shirts, so you're much more relaxed because it's so much lighter on your body. I play for a football team. If I go to training, then it's very cold, so I have to wrap up really warm. I'm never allowed to wear my team's shirt. And so in the summer when we play, it's much nicer because we get to wear our football kits. And on the matches, we don't have to wear these big baggy trousers because you might mishit the football. I don't think it would spoil Christmas if it were hot, because in Australia, they seem to manage and they have a turkey on the beach, and when they get up in the morning, it's always so hot, they go outside into their gardens and open their presents. If it was sunny here all the year round, then a lot more people would visit the country, and a lot more people would like it a lot more, because people are always travelling to other countries for the summer, so when it's really, really hot, but now they wouldn't have to. The economy would thrive in Britain because of all the sun and all the extra jobs that would go around. And so the people that work on the beaches that sell ice lollies and food would get a lot more money. If people complained about the hot weather and if they really got on our nerves, we could send them to Antarctica or the North Pole and see if they're happy there. I'm Charlie, and I wish that Britain were a sunnier place.
That's nearly it for CBBC on BBC One, but if you switch over to the CBBC channel in 15 minutes, you'll catch a brand new series of Bamzuki with Gemma and Barney.
Saturdays at 10, CBBC on BBC Two.